propel and move along. I'll show you exactly how it works in a second. Now we've got the side movement that helps us move left and right, and it seems to be a very interesting sort of insect design. It reminds me of some sort of praying mantis as it moves across the ground. We'll hop inside, and as we hop inside you can see we've got a radar screen on the right, we've got our batteries and information specs, as well as an ammo somewhere on the left. We've also got crawl controls up at the top left as well. So now we've turned that on, we can actually activate our rotors, and you'll notice as we activate our rotors it actually turns the systems on. But we can turn the system off if we want to by pressing number 2. I'll remove the hood. See how the ship is actually stopped in place. Now if we disable our rotors, you can actually see it just falls back down towards the ground. We'll re-enable them and we'll get this ship walking. Now what is quite shocking and exciting about it is how fast this ship actually moves across the ground. You can also turn it very easily using gyroscopes as we turn over here and get moving in this direction. There is a few bangs and clinks, but that is because the pistons are absorbing a lot of that shock. Now we have got some other options too, so if I just bring this to the stop and we press number 4. Number 4 will extend 2 decoys, and this will actually make the silhouette of this walker much taller. So if someone's trying to actually engage this ship, they'll fire rockets above if they're using automatic turrets. We can also pop that down and up as well. And we can also do something that I really like. This is the jump feature. You can see how it jumps up into the air on these pistons. And it can also walk like this if you so called want it to. See the pistons. It doesn't really work as well. I can see this being just more of a way of getting in and out of difficult spots. Maybe you need to climb up onto a rock, you can leap onto it by pressing 5 like so. You can leap up onto that rock and leap back down. Very nice little feature. We've also got thrusters in case we find ourselves in a situation where we actually need to take off. So as we can take off here and move around quite easily, we can also drop back down to the ground and continue walking. So back to 7 and we can reactivate our legs. So if you're like me, you're probably wondering what sort of offensive capabilities does this bring to the table. Now on the roof we have the single rocket launcher, to the left hand side we have the Gatling gun, so if I just activate that there you can see we can fire that, and to the right we have a double rocket launcher set up in volley fire by hitting number 9. You can see we can fire 2 rockets and it is quite close range and rather inaccurate, purely because we're moving up and down, so that automatic turret on the top would have to do a lot of the work. But I really like the idea of extending out these pistons as well as having control of these decoys on the back to actually make the silhouette a bit harder to hit with them automatic turrets. A very nifty idea indeed, and I guess that could also work as a self-righting system if you do flip this walker over. So I've taken the walker over to the alien world. Now there's 2 reasons I've done this. I want to see if I can fight any of them bugs, and secondly I want to do a little bit of off-road testing. So remember, we do have the thrusters, so if we do get in a spot of bother we can activate them and just thrust away. So technically we don't even need to try and go over this dangerous terrain, we can just activate our thrusters and hop down. I just wanted to see what it was actually capable of if it got stuck on something like this with the rocks. So there you go, you can see it's stuck and straight away it's not going anywhere at all. So I guess we could disable our systems like so, activate number 7 and just fly over it if we don't completely crash into the ground. We'll see how stuck we are first. Seems like we're pretty stuck. Let's activate number 4. We've got that up. And we can activate 5 to extend the pistons. And that should give us a little bit of lift. There we go. So we can actually move over to this terrain and then walk below. So it's a pretty nice idea. I really like the addition as well as the thrusters as well, because it allows you just to really adapt to the situation you find yourself in. So now that we're getting down here, we can re-enable all the settings. So back to a number 5. So we track them in. Oh, we're going a little bit fast, a little bit dangerous there. See if we can sweep around into this area. It doesn't fly very well, I'll tell you that. Right, don't hit that. Ah! Okay, seems like we're okay. We'll disengage our number 7, and we should be able to keep walking. Looks like the pistons have done their job in absorbing a little bit of that impact when we came down hard on that landing. So it seems like it's quite a functional little device. Definitely the rover I would turn to if I wanted a walker-based design. So I thought it'd be a good idea to do a little bit of bug hunting in this ship, just to see how it would behave, see if it'd actually be able to take out other bugs. There is a few problems with it. I've noticed that the bugs go straight underneath it, and when they're underneath it, they're very hard to get out. So we can press 3, stop the actual rover itself. You can see we've got the bug trap there. We can try to jump away, but what's going to happen is it'll just come out somewhere else. So let's actually reactivate our rotors and try to get a little bit of machine gun on this bug. No, we missed him. He's got back underneath us. We can try jumping out of it, maybe. Oh, we're jumping out. I think we lost a wheel in the process. Maybe hop back down, crush him underneath. No, he's escaped away. Okay, there he is. He's popping up over this side, so let's get our gun on him. There we go. We've got him finally.
want you to meet my daughters, Marie-Louise Pauline, because I can. Oh, merde. Now we're going to have flies up here.
There. That should do it.
Bastien, you want to rut like a beast? Then we're going to treat you like one. Where's my pickaninny with the head? Put it on him.
Darling, you have outdone yourself. However did you think this out?
My great literacy began with Greek mythology. I used to sit on Daddy's lap and he would read me those stories, full of their vengeful gods and wondrous, miraculous creatures. The Minotaur was always my favorite. Half man, half bull. And now, I have one of my very own.
About this?
Come on, I'm on Baton and Sex. Cliche, but like all cliches, it's the truth. Your life can change overnight or in a moment. The official word on Charlie's death was a brain aneurysm. The doctors had never seen anything quite like it before. The blood, all that blood.
It's not your fault, baby. It's ours. Something I should have told you a long time ago. I prayed it would skip your generation. Your great-grandmother had the same genetic affliction.
So, apparently I'm a witch. runs in my family. It doesn't show up in every generation or in every girl. Like my cousin Amanda, she's just bulimic. We read about the Salem witch trials in like fifth grade. Guess I should have paid more attention.
Mercy Osborne, you have been sentenced to death. May God have mercy on your wretched soul.
Those girls weren't even witches. The real witches were cunning and careful not to be caught. In fact, after that, they got the hell out of Dodge. They fled as far south as they could. That's how eventually New Orleans became the new Salem.
There's a school there. A boarding school for girls like you. You'll be safe.
You're sending me away?
I'm sorry, baby. We can't keep you here anymore. It's too dangerous.
What's going on? Mom, what's going on? What is this?
Drive her to the station?
She's our daughter now, Laurie. You've done all you can. A long goodbye would only make things worse.
Disconnected. Connected. Channel switched.